Hi friends, it's Mr. Terry's Talking Time, and I'm so happy to be here and spend some time with you guys. Our theme is the big sandbox and how Jesus is our friend. That's right, Jesus is my best friend. I have so many great friends in my life. And you know, when I was young, I loved playing Play-Doh with my friends. So I brought some today and I thought I would see how well I could still build sculptures like I used to. An image is going to come on the screen and we'll see how well I can build it. Okay, here we go, and it is a cat. Okay, well, how did I do? Let's see, I got one more. Okay, and it is a cross. Well, I've got this. This cross reminds me of Jesus and how much he loves us. This also makes me think of this month's question. Who loves you?
Thank you, Mr. Terry. I love when he comes to hang out with us. He's a good friend of mine. Hey, that makes me think of our verse. A friend loves at all times. Proverbs 17:17. Now let's say it together with the hand motions.
A friend loves at all times. Proverbs 17:17. A friend loves at all times. Proverbs 17:17.
Today in our story, we see a woman who's made some poor choices. She goes to attend a party and Jesus is there. She and Jesus start to talk, and the other people at the party think Jesus should stay away from her because of the things that she's done, because she messed up and made some poor choices. But Jesus did not stay away from her. In fact, he forgave her, and the woman was so thankful for his forgiveness, and she knew that he loves her no matter what. Let's go to the clubhouse and see how this story unfolds.
Hoo! Hoo! Know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have learning together. So let's go down to the clubhouse with Ollie and his friends. Let's go down to the clubhouse where wonder never ends at the Wonder Clubhouse.
Oh, hello there, friends. Welcome to the clubhouse. It's me, Poppy. My friends and I have had so much fun playing in the clubhouse sandbox. I brought some fun new toy sorts to play with today. Do you know what this is? It's called a sifter. See, these holes will let the sand through, but not big things. Let's see if there's anything bigger than sand in this bucket. Oh, look at that! There was something bigger than sand in my bucket. There's some seashells, like at the beach. I'm gonna save these to show to my friends later. Do you know what this is? It's called a funnel. You can pour things through it like this. I know. Let's see if we can fill the bottle of sand using the funnel. I'll just put it right here. Oh no! sand is everywhere. It's all over the floor. I've made the biggest mess. Zoe's gonna be so mad at me.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie.
Hi there, Poppy. Who? Who? Is something the matter with you?
Hey, Ollie. I was having so much fun with my sand toys, but then I made a big mess. Zoe loves this sandbox so much. She's gonna be really mad at me.
I understand how you feel. It's true. I have the perfect story for you. Just listen to this. Just follow me through. Who? Who?
Follow me through. Follow me through who? Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Oh, hey, friends. I'm Justin the Mailman with lots of letters for the neighborhood. But this one is actually from me to my friend Aisha. I dropped some of her cupcakes the other day, so I wrote her an I'm sorry card. I think she'll forgive me because she's always been my friend no matter what. Which reminds me of our story today. Are you ready for it? I'll just put the story mail in the mailbox and... Today's true story from the Bible begins with a special dinner for Jesus. As Jesus and the people were eating and talking, a woman who was not invited walked in, carrying a bottle of perfume. Now, this woman had made a lot of bad choices, so the people at the dinner did not think they would see her there. Look, what is she doing? She's sitting at Jesus' feet and she's crying. She's crying because Jesus had forgiven her for making bad choices. She knows Jesus loves her no matter what. The woman was so thankful Jesus loved her. She wanted to do something special for him. So she started to wash his feet. The woman washed Jesus' feet with her tears and dried them with her hair. Then she poured perfume on his feet. The people at the party thought Jesus should stay away from her. You don't know what she's done, they said. But Jesus just smiled. Because Jesus did know. Jesus knew everything the woman had done, and he could see how sorry she was and how much she loved him. So Jesus told her, "Woman, you are forgiven. Now go in peace." Friends, there is absolutely nothing you could ever do to make Jesus stop loving you. He loves you no matter what. Jesus loves you, and he wants to be your friend forever. Oh, hey there, Ollie. Tell me, who loves you?
Jesus loves me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who loves you?
Jesus loves me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. I'll see you next time.
So there's your story. It's all true. The woman was thankful for Jesus, and he showed he loved her too.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Who? Who?
Wow, what a great story. The woman poured perfume on Jesus' feet to show him that she was thankful for him. Jesus loved the woman no matter what, and Jesus loves us no matter what, too. I think I got the story. Did you get it? If you did, say, got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good! And you know what? Jesus loves me even when I make a mess. I'm gonna clean this up and tell my friends that I'm sorry for stealing the sand. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
I love this story because it shows how much Jesus loves the woman no matter what. And you know who else he loves no matter what? You! Yes, he loves you so much, and nothing you can ever do will ever change that. Jesus loves you and wants to be your friend forever. This is the last week of this month, so I want you to answer this question one last time, super loud, okay? Who loves you? Yes, Jesus loves me. Great job. Now it's time for our song, a whole lot of it. So stand to your feet and let's sing.
His love will never quit. His love will never run away. Even when I get upset, his love is still forgiving me. And it's all because, all because his love isn't just a little bit. He loves me a whole lot.
Jesus with you. I want you to remember this week how much Jesus loves you and nothing can ever change that. Let's pray. Get those hands ready. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Give a little clap. Open, shut them, open, shut them. Fold them in your lap. God, we thank you for another week of learning about how much Jesus loves us. God, we thank you for the lesson today where we see that nothing we can do will ever make Jesus stop loving us. We thank you that when we do mess up or make a mistake, that we are forgiven and you still love us. We thank you and we ask for a great week. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a great week, everybody.